Most of us take our sense of hearing for granted, but sounds like birds chirping, buses going by, or a parent's voice are not accessible to many Americans. In the 1980s, a device called a cochlear implant helped many people gain access to the sounds in their world.
Although cochlear implants were successful at helping people understand speech and children acquire language, people still had remarkable challenges listening in noisy environments and being able to know where sounds are coming from. We are discovering how the brain is able to take information that is arriving at the two ears and to help people function in realistic, complex, noisy, everyday situations.
Litovsky and her colleagues at the Waisman Center at UW-Madison are helping children with cochlear implants function more effectively in everyday environments. And families travel from all over the country to take part in her research. Braden Gallenfeld from Iowa first came to the lab 7 years ago when he had one implant. Now 11, he has a second implant, and thanks in part to the team in Madison, he's doing great.
It turned out pretty good. I can hear without it now, and it's really nice. I can hear my teacher and my friends. I can actually locate sound. And I'm actually kind of glad that I'm not in a special school, and I can have normal friends and not have help.
While the implants help Braden function in the mainstream world, the victories don't come without challenges.
When I was 7 months pregnant, I was exposed to a child who had CMV, cytomegalovirus. So we knew when he was born to expect that he might have some issues. And he was born asymptomatic, so he was fine. He passed his newborn hearing screening, everything was fine. And then we had him checked again. We went through that process a couple different times, and then they finally gave him a sedated hearing test, and he failed that. So we found out when he was 3 months old that he was deaf. We wanted him to be able to hear music, and we wanted him to be able to hear us say, I love you, and I wanted him to be able to say that back.
So you're always pretty sure if it's on the yellow side or on the green side?
Mm-hmm. For the families and the participants who are willing to give up their time and their energy to come and be part of this, to help us learn about how they're hearing. We're just really grateful. There is, in our heart, a huge gratitude for all that they're doing to help the science continue forward.
There's nothing better than knowing that all the work that we've been doing has paid off in providing for the patients what they most want, which is improvement in quality of life and ability to communicate.